Better? Yes? No? It's gonna have to pick me up from over there too, because I'm not gonna be shuffling this thing all around forever. Alright, what about now? It's gonna take like 30 seconds for the stream to catch up. So, I'm just gonna start getting ingredients out. And then once you guys have caught up, the delay is gone. Okay. We're good? Good? Volume good? I really wish I just had somebody sitting, like, in my living room just, like, so they could tell me. Step over and test. Yeah, I'm gonna kind of move this a little bit over more. This is not how we're doing all of the baking streams. This is just until I get that thing figured out. I spent enough money on it. I'm gonna make it work. I just don't want to make you guys wait. So we're gonna get this started. I'm actually gonna start by mixing together the streusel topping, because as you can see, we've got, like, muffins, and then there's like streusel on top of them, and I want to mix together the streusel first because that's going to need to go on before they go in the oven, and I just want to have it ready. So for the streusel, basically they want you to rub some butter into salt, flour, brown sugar, cinnamon, and oats. So I need to go get those things. Some butter. A lot of salt. Flour. Brown sugar. All right. I didn't remember how many sugars I needed, so I got all the sugars. And then oats are over there. Okay, this should do. So we're just gonna like get a little bowl. I have less dishes than I thought I had. You have your phone, I can text you updates. Yeah, let me grab my phone. I probably know where my phone is. I have a bad habit of losing my phone at home. Okay. Let me see if I can make this make noise. I don't think I've ever heard my phone make noise at me. I just check it, like, once a day. Not very often. People get mad at me. They're like, you didn't text me back. And I'm like, it's still today, right? If I miss a whole calendar day, then we've got a problem. All right. Okay. Yeah, this flour bin is heavy, heavy duty. I got like a big one for brown sugar, and then it occurred to me, I don't know when I'm ever gonna need this much brown sugar. Okay, so. It's warm in here. It's only gonna get warmer too. Oats. So I need a half a cup of rolled oats. Now, I have. So I'm not really 100% clear on the difference between rolled oats and other kinds of oats. So I just have like this big bag of oats. This is just gonna have to work. Now that I have the audio out, I could probably plug in the other camera, but actually I can't because this is USB 2. So we're gonna mix together. I'll make sure to show you guys on the big camera. I can also move the big camera, but I will drop it, and it's kind of expensive. Okay. It started it. So how are you guys doing today? I'm surprised that that you guys are, like, here on a Monday morning. I know it would make a lot more sense to do the baking streams on weekends, but can't do that. Feed the children of the world. I mean, I'm gonna have about 12 muffins to work with, so I will feed as many people as I can with 12 muffins, which is probably gonna be about 4. So we're gonna need to mix some salt, 1/3 cup of flour. So it says a pinch of salt. I can't really pinch this. I enjoy how on the container, not only is this a giant thing of salt, but it also says free flowing salt, and I feel like that there's a joke in there somewhere, but that we'll just have to do. 1/3 cup of flour. These muffins better be good because I am starving. I'm so hungry. I promise I don't normally forget to eat. Only during like WoW expansion launches. And this morning, I guess. All right, so 1/3 cup of this. It's weird. I wouldn't have thought that the streusel topping would have flour in it, but I guess it does. Similar amount of brown sugar. It's 6 p.m. in the UK and I'm so hungry. You should make some muffins, man. dude or dudette. I think these are about 15 times fancier than any other muffin that I've ever made in my whole life. I feel like I made blueberry muffins once in high school. That's the thing I should also warn you guys about, is when I'm doing these baking streams, I'm wearing an apron, which I know makes me look very much like an official baking expert. I don't bake very often. I have very limited experience. I'm good at following directions. I'm good at forgetting directions. 1 teaspoon of cinnamon. And then I just need to rub the butter in. We can rub some butter. Cinnamon. This is one of those like Costco things of cinnamon, and it's like, when are you? It's so much. Who uses this much cinnamon in like a year? Like every place I've ever lived in had one of these, and it existed before I got there, and it existed at roughly the same level after I left. And I've never in my life seen somebody finish one of these. Will you stream Tomb? No, I don't even raid Tomb tomorrow. And also I don't stream my live raids anymore, or stream my raids live anymore. That was causing some issues. So basically my plan, my guild raids Wednesday, Thursday nights. I am going to be there for the first week of Tomb. The second week of Tomb, I may or may not miss some of it because I'm going out of town. But I'm going to record our kills, and then I'm going to use our kills to make videos, and I'm going to make video guides for every boss. I don't know when they'll be up. They'll be up like long after all the other video guides. Kind of like an afterthought, but I'm gonna make a video for each boss, but I'm not gonna stream all the raids. You're doing the end of your priest mount quest now? I love the priest mount quest. It was 100% better than any of the other ones I've done so far, which was one. I guess the monk one was cool. Like, I did my monk class mount quest, and I enjoyed it, but, hang on, I need 3 teaspoons of this. These wrappers are all like, I'm gonna measure this for you, but then they're never on straight. So, I mean, it's just a streusel. It's not like this is part of the baking, so we're just gonna, like, pull off that much. But yeah, I guess the problem with the monk one was I wanted my mount, and I just wanted to be done with it, and it kept making me do stuff, and it was like, well, now go here, now fly all over Pandaria, now, like, go to this class hall that you've forgotten how to get to, and I just wanted my time. Okay, so I've got just a bowl of stuff. We're gonna rub some butter in here. I love your hair, thank you. I need to figure out what I'm doing with my hair in my life. Like, this is too big. I need to stab that.
I need to wash my hands and then stab that.
Like, I have a vision of what I want my hair to look like, but my hair in my head, like, disagrees violently, and it refuses to cooperate. And I feel like I'm trying something different every week, and very rarely does it turn out the way I want it to, but eventually. Don't mind me, I'm just stabbing butter over here. This is just a bowl full of, like, flour and sugar and oats and no butter. And in smaller pieces, I bet I'll be able to rub it in like they want me to, but for now, I'm just gonna kinda stab. Did you enjoy the Halls of Stone part of the mount quest? I got so annoyed by that. It was a little bit long, but the opposite of a problem. The nice thing about that is that was the only combat that they wanted you to do, and there was very little traveling around. The only other class mount that I did involved a lot of running around and a lot of travel time, and that was annoying. At least with the priest one, they kind of took you where you were going to go, you did the stuff they wanted you to do there, and then they gave you your mount, and a lot of it was actually RP. Which I am only slightly ashamed to say I actually just didn't. I just went AFK. I just kind of waited for it to be over with. Alright, so I'm just going to squish this all up. You finished up Locke last night? You got 4 mans down? Are you going to get all of them? I don't remember, Skaterbun, if you have all of the classes at 110, but I thought you had a lot of them. Yeah, the wireless mic is that dream. That dream is dead for now. I'm going to try and fix it for the next time, but it depends on what it needs to get, what it needs from me in order to fix it. We'll see. It wasn't the most expensive wireless mic setup in the world. Like, the mic itself was about $35, and then it was like another $35 for the audio interface and like another $10 for like an adapter. And I guess it might have been asking too much to get like a working wireless mic setup, but it worked until I started streaming. Hazel murders butter. News 11. Yo, sup, Adam? How you doing? Thanks to you, I finally stopped being lazy and got my monk class mount. I do love the monk class mount and that I have it, though. Also, congratulations on yours. I played with dialogue sound on so I could listen to the voice acting of him talking to me. And that was really cute for like a day. And then I was like, dude, shut up. I'm done. You don't have enough things to say to justify how often you say it, especially if you're like running around doing a quest. And it's just running around doing a quest, and you know, you get off your mount, you collect the quest objective, you get back on your mount, and he's like, where are we going today, Grandmaster? And I'm like, the same place we were going 45 seconds ago, man. Just calm down. Is the priest class mount underwater? Kind of. You know what you should do is you should just, like, level a priest and do the whole campaign and go get it. It's fun. Or I have a video. But that's not as much fun. Okay, so I don't know if I've rubbed this in enough. Maybe, I think I need smaller pieces. The problem is it's so warm in here that this is going to start to melt. And I don't know if that's ideal. Maybe I should put this in the fridge. I'm going to do that. Once I get this, like, a little bit more streusel-y, I'm just going to put this in the fridge. Because otherwise this is going to be, like, gunk. This is going to be, like, cinnamony sugar flour gunk. And that's just not what I want to put on my muffins. Paladin class mount at 110. Oh, no. I want to do more of them. But I'm kind of tapped on alt leveling time. I still don't have the monk pet.
I'm close. I have Breaching the Tomb done, so I got my class now. And so all I need to do is get Concordance of Legion Fall, and I think I only need like 3 more points. And I have I only need like 3 more points, and I have all of the research, obviously, because it only takes 4 hours now. So
I just need to, like, do, like, 3 days worth of all of the AP quests. I just never have time to do 3 days worth of all the AP quests. I can barely keep up with, like, one emissary on my main. You're quite fond of the rogue class mount? That one might be my favorite. I need to play my rogue a little bit more to get the crackers pet. I'm specifically managing my alts in relation to what kind of pets they can get me.
Okay, so that is some streusel too. That is for later. I am absolutely going to forget to duck under
that thing at some point and knock it right the heck over. I already knocked over. I've got behind this. One day I'll actually do like a video that shows like what I've got kind of behind the camera here. But I've got 2 big softbox lights and I knocked one of them over. It was kind of top heavy. But I knocked one of them over and it plowed over my Brita filter. And that was a little messy. The cat was quite upset.
Okay. So we have streusel topping. So now we need to actually mix up the muffins. So
I guess I can preheat the oven. It's gonna cook me. I don't want to melt. All right. Well, we're just mixing a bunch of stuff together, so I guess I should preheat it now. Oh, man. Okay. So, move this a little bit closer so I can kind of chat while looking over my shoulder at you guys here. Keep all this stuff. There's so many things in these muffins. These have more ingredients than any other muffins I've ever seen in my whole life. Okay. Alright. Where'd my book go? Milk? I'm putting milk in later. It wants me to put milk and then vinegar. Isn't that gonna do something weird? I guess I'll start with the applesauce. It takes half a cup of applesauce. And I bought applesauce just for this purpose, and I have no idea what I'm gonna do with, like, 2 pounds of applesauce minus half a cup. Like, what do you even use applesauce for? Do I just eat it? I guess I could just eat it. Not the Brita filter. The Brita filter's fine. It's been knocked over a lot of times. It neatly split into like 6 pieces and they all just neatly went back together, so. Oh man. Oh, I did it. I was about to get worried. Usually this is quite 1950s of me, but usually if I can't get a jar open, I just like find the nearest man and I'm like, help. Help me. I can't. But I gotta work on my muscles. Get Hazel Swole or something like that. All right, so half a cup of that, approximately. I guess I put it in the fridge now. Seriously, I haven't had applesauce since I was like 2 years old. Must refrigerate after opening, okay. Also, you guys wouldn't believe how far away chat is. I can barely see it. Weren't you going to use a head mic? I had one. It's
a tragic story. We thought it was gonna work until we tried it, and it worked for about a minute, and then it stopped working. All right, so applesauce, brown sugar, oil, egg, vanilla. So how much brown sugar are we talking? We need half a cup. I guess I should wash that cup. I don't nearly have enough measuring cups. Although I feel like having too many of them is just gonna make more dishes. I would rather do the dishes as I go than try and
trying to do the other way. At least this audio is going to be better than last week. Last week's hurt me. I was like editing the beginning out of the VOD, and I was watching it. And I was like, oh god, how did you guys even stay here? I wouldn't. I'm kind of a quality snob when it comes to watching people's streams and vlogs and stuff. Like, if it looks good and it sounds good, I'll listen to somebody say almost, not almost anything, but like my standards are a lot lower. But if your camera's awful or like your mic sucks, I'm very snobby about that. Okay, half a cup brown sugar. I'm just gonna triple check all of my amounts because I will, like, I know how, what's the word? I don't want to say airheaded because that's not a very nice word. But I tend to be a little bit spacey when I'm streaming, as you might have noticed if you've seen in my WoW streams. So, I'd rather not get any of this wrong. A third of a cup of vegetable oil. I love these snapware things. I want just to have all of the things in my kitchen in these snapware. So, it's oil. One third. All of the, oh, no, that's a quarter. All of the little markers have worn off, so I kind of have to just, like, guess. Oh, that's definitely too big. How do I have so many quarters and no thirds? Where did they go? That's a half. Ah, found it. Got it. Ugh. Vegetable oil. So it wants me to use apple cider vinegar, and I have apple cider vinegar, but I don't know if it goes bad. It's vinegar. You'd think it wouldn't. Like, people preserve food in this. Best if used by date on the bottle. Well, that's not a date. Oh, maybe it's a date. If it's good until 2026, then I've got a couple years still. Yeah, it smells like apple cider vinegar. I feel like I bought this like 5 years ago when I was trying to use it as part of like a hair care thing. Which didn't work, by the way. It just made me smell like apples. A tablespoon of that. I had spoons. Here they are. I'm here. Not really that late. Nah, we're just getting started here. So, one tablespoon? Yes, tablespoon. I'm nervous about putting milk and vinegar in the same bowl. Like, I know it's not gonna, like, blow up or anything, but it just seems very strange to me. It seems like something you don't do. Alright. Vinegar, applesauce, sugar, oil, vanilla. Teaspoon vanilla. And then I also need an egg. I should have lots of eggs. I've been eating eggs for breakfast every day, and by eggs I mean one. But it's nothing at, like, if I don't have an egg for breakfast in the morning, I feel like I'm just running on empty. Like, I can't do anything. My brain doesn't even wake up until like 1 o'clock in the afternoon. Okay. So I need the egg and the milk. I want to reach out. It's so far away. Vinegar doesn't expire, but the taste can go a little wonky. But there's only like a little bit of it in the whole muffin thing, so we're gonna, if it makes it really weird, then I'll know that's probably why. Okay. How much milk? A cup? A cup? A whole cup? I'm gonna need more milk. Alright. Ah! That was the best egg cracking I've ever done in my whole life. I'm so bad at that. Okay, milk. This is fine. This is good. This will do. Is there a cup in here? I have no idea. That's about a cup. Maybe a little bit more. Ah! Milk vinegar explosion. Ah! Kidding. You've never used applesauce anything, you just heat it up? I'll have to try that, because I don't know what I'm going to do with the rest of the applesauce. Okay. So I have beaten together milk, vinegar, applesauce, brown sugar, oil, egg, vanilla. Add the spices. Spices. Oh, I see. You want me to measure some cinnamon and ginger. Okay. I got ginger. I got more cinnamon. I need to wash my spoons, though. Moser's explosive muffins. You appreciated the egg cracking sound effects. I didn't. Did I make an egg cracking sound effect? I thought it. Maybe it was just the egg cracking sound. Maybe that was just the best egg crack, to the point that you were just amazed by how wonderful the sound was. Okay, so spices. We need 1 teaspoon of ginger, or 1/2 teaspoon of ginger, 1 teaspoon of cinnamon. Approximately here. I should be leveling these off, but I'm in a hurry, so I'm just kind of shaking them out. I'm doing everything my home ec teacher told me not to do as a kid. All right, so that's about cinnamon, ginger. I love ginger. I put ginger in not everything, but a lot of things. And also, gingerbread is definitely not just for Christmas. It weirds me out that they make gingerbread cookies and they sell them here year-round, but if it's not Christmas time, they don't call it gingerbread. They call it something else. But it's the same stuff. I swear it's the same stuff. So it told me to put muffin liners in here, but then I realized I once again don't have any, so I'm just going to do the thing where I like butter it and then flour it, because that seemed to work good last time. So I'm going to grab just like a little bit of flour. Also, I feel like these muffins don't have, there's got to be flour in them eventually. Maybe they're, oh yeah, there's flour later. Okay. I'm thinking, when do I add the flour? These are just batter forever. So this is the best method that I found for making something nonstick, was to not only butter it, but also flour it. Although, I really think this would be better with muffin liners, especially because it would make them like more portable. But what are you going to do? I just got to remember. I could get such cute ones. They make such adorable muffin liners. You guys know what I wanted to make in one of these baking streams? Was I wanted to decorate sugar cookies, because wanted to decorate sugar cookies because the cake decorating set, also like those little weird squeezy bottles we used last time, would also work just fine for icing. And I wanted to make like little dragons or unicorns or something. I looked into the WoW cookie cutters, but they're not very good looking. Like, A, they're plastic, and I much prefer using like a metal cookie cutter. B, they're one of those ones that puts like little baby super tiny indents that like get completely destroyed by the art of baking them. Active baking them. And D, they're not even especially Warcrafty. They don't, I don't know. Do any of you have the WoW cookie cutters? Do they make good, like, Merlot cookies? Because they don't look like they will. So that's been buttered. Birthday. Happy birthday, Jans. I wish I could make you guys the chat bigger. Is there a way to pop out the chat? There must be. I'm making a massive mess. Every time I do one of these baking streams, I finish it, and I'm like, man, a tornado just tore through my kitchen. Okay, so now I need to add in oats, and then baking powder, baking soda, baking soda. Okay, how much oats? How many? 4? 2? 1 cup. Where'd my cup go? I had a big cup. I lost it. Here it is. So, again, we're gonna, like, there may, or maybe, there's a very definite, solid chance that I'm using the wrong kind of oats. And if that's true, we're just gonna find out. These are not instant oats. These are the other ones. Yeah. 2 teaspoons baking powder. Also the, and then 1/2 a teaspoon of baking soda. The recipes always have, like, time to prepare, and they're always like, oh, it'll take you about 7 minutes to put this together, and then 25 minutes to bake, so, you know, in 32 minutes you can be eating muffins. I don't think I've ever made a recipe in, like, half of that time in my entire life. Never. Even when I get everything ready ahead of time. Okay. Stir in the flour 1 cup at a time until it becomes batter, and then divide evenly between the muffin cups. Okay, how much flour? 2 cups. 2 cups flour. I had a cup. Found it. Your PS3 is like 10 seconds behind your computer. There's a YouTube makes use of a fairly heavy stream delay, and I think part of it has to do with the way it DVRs things. Like, you can roll it back if you want to check something from like 30 seconds ago. And 1 cup. I'm just gonna put both cups in at once. I'm living my life on the edge. Ah! I almost spilled that all over myself. Almost. To get this white sugar, I don't think I need it at all. I don't think that's necessary for anything. Oh, yeah. Oh, that looks so good. Okay, so how do I show you? I don't want to move the camera because I'll never get it put back where it was. But I promise you this smells like amazing apple oat muffins. Well, if the vinegar was bad, I would never know, because that's delicious. I was watching the stream and shopping for food, and I almost ran into a lady. Oh no! Are you shopping for the ingredients to get the muffins? Because I feel like everybody on the planet should own the WoW cookbook. I have to restrain myself from, like, selling the cookbook to people that don't even play WoW. I'm like, man, you want a soft pretzel recipe? I know where to hook you up. So we need to just divide this evenly between 12. Thank goodness that it does not want me to make more than 12 muffins, because again, we only got the 1 muffin tray. Yeah. It's really hard to not just eat batter. I feel like with baked goods, a lot of the time, even like you're not supposed to eat the batter because it's got rye egg, and then you can get like diseases, salmonella, chicken pox, you know, whatever. So, you're not supposed to eat the batter, but I feel like the batter almost always tastes, like, better than the finished product. Obviously, it's not as convenient, but you could totally put this muffin batter on top of ice cream and just be like, yo, this is dessert. This is the best dessert. Like, I bet a really exclusive restaurant would probably do that. Because people put rye eggs in desserts, if they're, like, fancy rich people that can afford to get sick. You know, they've got, like, health insurance, and they can take days off work, that kind of thing. I have way more. These are going to be the most huge muffins. These are going to be gigantic. Because it's like divide evenly between... Did it really say 12? No, it says makes 12 muffins. All right, well, I'm just going to keep dividing this. These are going to be huge because these are going to rise, right? So if the muffin cup is full, these are going to be some big muffins. I can have some big muffins. It's fine. I mean, it only makes 12 of them. I want them to be good, right? My WoW cookbook right in front of me right now. Well, we are playtesting the Moser's Magnificent Muffins. I tried them. I figured because I didn't have the second camera around this time, I figured, well, maybe I can actually finally turn that first camera back to 60 frames per second, because it actually looked a lot clearer. Not only just faster, but clearer. But it still had an issue, a delay issue, and I think that computer just can't quite parse that amount of info, let alone updated. It was like offsetting on the recording. So obviously the answer is just to save up a bunch of money and buy like a bunch of really crazy computers. I want to build a new computer for kitchen streaming, but for just like regular rendering and whatever. With one of those new Intel i9s. Like, they're real expensive. They go between like $1,000 and $2,000 for just the processor. But dang if they don't have good looking specs. We don't know everything about them so far because they're not out yet. But they promise me things that I want. Okay. Cause my current computer tends to cry and complain at me when I'm trying to make it render some certain things in Premiere. Alright, well, this looks about even. I've lost some batter over there, but that's fine. Don't forget to do the PvP ball. I'll try and do it at least on my main. I wanted to record a video of that PvP ball because it looked like it wouldn't take very long to do. And I wanted to make a video for like maybe next Sunday. Okay, so now that I have my muffin batter in the tin, it wants me to carefully spoon it on top of the filled muffin cups and press very gently to bond the two. So we're gonna bond some streusel topping on top of some muffin batter. I have a lot of streusel topping. Also, some of these pieces of flour or butter in here are kind of huge still. I have so much. How am I even going to fit all of this? These muffins are going to escape the pan and grow legs and walk out to, like, terrorize my dog in like, another room. Which my dog will probably just... He won't even eat the muffin. He'll be scared. He would be scared of a talking muffin. He wouldn't even try to eat it. He would just run away. My dog is not very brave. Oh, man. Maybe this isn't so bad. Maybe I have enough. Or enough muffin to put all this onto, anyways. It's not going to be an issue to press gently to bond the two because I've got like half an inch of streusel on top of each muffin. One more over here. Sure. And at the end of this, we have like, I think it's like nutmeg maple icing that we drizzle all on top of it. But we got to bake them first. I'm tapping gently. I'm making the executive decision to go for a tap instead of a press. Because that's what having a baking stream is all about, is making important decisions like that. Joker's a decent pupper. He's a quality pupper. So we have muffins. And now they go in the oven. For 25 minutes. So, once those are done and cooled down a little bit, we're gonna drizzle the icing on them. In the meantime, I'm gonna try and mitigate the disaster that's happened in my kitchen so far, and then I'm gonna get my stool out so we can sit and chat. Also, I feel like there's one more thing I need to do. I don't remember. But I'm gonna clean up a little bit. This is where the cooking show gets awkward. I mean, if you wanted to go smoother through the part where I'm cleaning my kitchen, you can always just, like, come clean my kitchen. Let's go here. If this was a children's show, I would have, like, a real cool song. I would have, like, some kind of a crazy cleanup song that makes this all go faster, and then, like, people wearing, like, skin-tight bodysuits with weird caps on them would come out to help me. And they would probably do it while doing, like, weird interpretive dance. I would be on board with that. This one over here. There are so many ingredients in these muffins. There are so many. One, two. Four. I'm gonna move this over a little bit. Are you gonna watch the chat? Of course, yeah. If you guys have any questions, I can do a little Q&A while I'm washing my dishes. This Tyler One's baking stream. I mean, if you want it to be, it can be whatever you want, man. You need a puppet? I would need a puppet. I should get a puppet. Yo, we would have the coolest puppet. I feel like it would probably be a squirrel. I feel like we'd probably end up with a squirrel puppet. Oh no, I got batter on my book. I guess that's what it's... I guess it's pretty normal. It's pretty standard to get a little bit of baking on your baking books. Usually I hope for the best, but I can't lie and say I wasn't half hoping for a giant explosion of batter and vinegar. I mean, it was never going to explode. That's just not a thing that was chemically going to happen unless somebody replaced my vinegar with something that actually explodes. But, you know what might explode? Is those muffin tins were real full. Those were super full. Where's the background in music? That I should actually set up. But the problem, like, I just want to make sure it wouldn't get, like, old, because it would be looping for, like, 2 hours of what's probably a 45-second music clip. Oh, man. What are some teas you recommend? Oh, man. Don't make me go on my tea cupboard tour. It really depends on what kind of tea you're looking for. So, here, I'm not quite done yet. So there's green teas. Black teas. Oolong teas. Pu'er teas. And then there's teas that aren't teas at all. So things like peppermint tea, bamboo tea, fruit tea. There's also flavored teas where you'll get like a cheaper grade of tea, but then somebody will have like infused it with like vanilla Axe body spray. So there's like a whole world of a billion different things. And you kind of got to pick a category before you start getting your recommendations. It would be like if I told somebody to recommend me a beer, or not even a beer, an alcoholic beverage, and they're like, you want wine? You want craft beer? You want an IPA? Like, what's up? Those smell really, really good. My guild wiped and goes down to 3%. Oh no! Oh no! But yeah. Dragonwell is a very good starter green tea. Black teas. I like the golden monkey varieties of black teas. Jinzhuang. I don't remember how to say it, but there's a not English name for it. But black, those are really good. Good starter ones. For an oolong tea, I really like recommending Taiguan Yin to people because it's usually pretty easy to find. Not super expensive, but like a really nice kind of floral oolong tea. GTA 5 drama going on right now? What's the GTA 5 drama? I never heard of it. Hazel, what are you drinking? I'm drinking water. It used to have ice in it, but that ice is long gone. Love how clumsy you get it sometimes. Yeah, that's all the time. That's my whole life. I'm 24 years old and I still can't turn a corner in a hallway without clipping right into it. It's not like I can't see. I have very good vision. I don't need glasses at all. My glasses I wear at my desk are just gaming glasses. I just don't quite make the corner. How are the muffins coming along? They are in the oven. They smell delightful. They have streusel topping on them, and then I'm just gonna clean up the dishes, and we're gonna mix up some maple nutmeg icing to drizzle over them. Honestly, these are more like muffins than or cupcakes than muffins. Something green or herbal, I always wanted to try that. I love my pu'er, I need to get some more. Okay, so if you can get a good Dragonwell, a good Longjing green tea. The one that I have that I really like is from Tao of Tea in Portland, but I know that not everybody lives near Portland. They do ship worldwide, but they ship with UPS, so the shipping's gonna cost you a little bit. But I'm sure that most places that will sell you a good authentic green tea, or oolong tea, or even pu'er tea, might be able to get you a Dragonwell, a Longjing. I actually recently, this morning, actually just ordered a little bit more tea from Yunnan Sourcing, is where I like to get my Chinese tea. I got 3 new black teas and 3 new pu'er teas because I'm down to just one black tea that I'm drinking for breakfast, and I like mixing it up. Best tea I ever tried, it's a little too sweet if you drink it fast, but if you drink it slow, it's really good. Ah, nice. I don't really put sugar in my tea anymore. Sometimes I have one. I have one flavored tea. It's a flavored black tea. It's from Harney & Sons, and it's called their Paris Blend. And it's like a vanilla caramel black tea. It's very nice. And that one I find is really good with a little bit of milk and just a little bit of sugar or honey. But I only ever do that, like, on a weekend. When I'm, like, kind of taking it easy. Would you take a ride in my McKenna hog? I like my lion's tabard. Isn't it great? It's got big pockets and stuff. I just don't know what I would put in them. I don't know what I would use the big pockets for, but I have them, which is nice. I have a lovely little tea shop downtown. That's where I get most of my tea. Yeah, see if they could hook you up with some Dragonwell. That's one of my favorites. I'm 30 and I walk into walls, mind you, when I see a good-looking guy. Normally my husband, aw. Aw, that's cute. Oh. I would like to make some tea, but it's actually so warm in here. Whenever it gets really hot like this, it's going to be about 90s today Fahrenheit, which is like 30 Celsius, and it's already warmer than that in here because I've got like some lights in the oven and whatever. So whenever it's hot like this, I'll just drink like a lot of tea really early, and then I'll just stop because it's too hot, and I'll just drink like iced tea or just water. You have the same microwave oven and stove as me? Yeah, this is an apartment, like we rent here, so this is just a what came with the apartment. I'm sure once I actually buy a house, my appliances are not going to be half as nice, but these work okay. Although the oven is a little bit too smart for it on its own good. If it decides that it's too hot, like keeping something boiling for a long period of time at a low temperature. Simmering. If you've been simmering something for like a long time, like over an hour, and you're also running the oven, such as you would when you're making like Thanksgiving dinner or something, it goes, I'm too hot. You must have forgotten about me. I'm going to scream at you until you cool me down. And it's really hard to cool down a hot oven, and it's really annoying when you're like in the middle of cooking something, and it's just a little bit too smart for its own good. I love that the channel's morphing into half tea appreciation, half wow one. I mean, as long as somebody wants to listen to me talk about tea, I'm probably not going to shut up. It's kind of one of my things. I don't know if I'm always going to be this crazy about tea, because usually there's a thing that I get really into, and I'll get super, super duper into it for like a year. Or maybe like 2 years. And before tea, it was succulent plants. And before succulent plants, I had actually a brief baking phase before I started my YouTube channel. That was like, it didn't last very long because I couldn't make anything. I wasn't good at any of it. But yeah. I have such a delightful collection of tea now that I can't really imagine not drinking it all the time. I subscribed, all thanks. Whew. I thought most places in the US had AC. So this place didn't come with AC. We're in Oregon, so like it depends on where you are. In Oregon, nobody expects it to get hot enough for you to need AC, but you absolutely do. Especially in the summer, like near Portland. It's gotten really hot the last couple of summers. So what we did is we got some window AC units. So we have one in a room over here. We've got another one in a room that way. And they do a good job in those rooms. And they keep it, like, livable in the main space. But I am pretty much right here in the kitchen as far as humanly possible. I could not be any farther from both of those ACs. And I have the oven right behind me, so it's going to get a little warmer just in here. You find living in Oregon that most places don't have AC because it rarely gets hot? Yeah. It just started getting hot like in the last like 3 years during the summers. You know, we get like 90, 100 degree days and it's awful. It's going to be 119 tomorrow and I got lucky because I'm living in Cancun. At least in Cancun people expect it to be hot. I've been here since around 8K and your videos are amazing. Aw, thank you. Do you use fountain pens? No. Should I? Should I use fountain pens? I know some people get like super into pens. I do actually write on paper every day. I have a list. Like, I keep a legal pad around, and I use it to write down, like, what my goals are for the day, like, my videos, and the different steps so I can, like, check them off one by one, and, like, anything else I need to do in that day, I'll, like, put on my list. And I use a pen for that, but I pretty much just use a cheap ballpoint pen, and it kind of gets the job done. Okay, so I am going to mix up... you know what? I'm going to mix up the frosting once they're actually cooling, and right now I'm just going to grab some ice and my stool, and we can sit down and chat. We've got about 13, 14 minutes, until the muffins come out of the oven, at which point we're gonna cool them on some trays. Do I have any Hearthstone ice cubes left? The Hearthstone ice cubes are really cute, but they're really hard to get out of their tray. Hey Hazel, I made it in one of your baking streams. Welcome, Robert. What's up? Do I like fountain drinks? What do you mean a fountain drink, like soda? I don't really drink a lot of, I have a hard time drinking like a super sugary drink unless I'm like, going at it like it's a dessert. Like I'll enjoy the pants off of one of those like super sugary Starbucks drinks, but that is my dessert for like the day. I can't just have one like as a regular drink. So So I don't drink a whole lot of soda or pop, as we call it in Canada. Your tattoo, is it from WoW? Does it have a message, or is it just because it looks amazing? So it's not from WoW. I have two tattoos. I have this arm, and then I have there's a maple leaf back here. Neither one of them are from anything. They're just kind of, this one's a cherry blossom tree, and that's a maple leaf. But I like tattoos that are just kind of art. And it could have a meaning if you wanted to have a meaning, but honestly, the reason I have two tree-related tattoos is because I think trees are cool. It doesn't really go a whole lot deeper than that. And I want to get more, so I want to get on my left ankle. It's not going to be anytime soon because I can't get this ice cube out of this tray! I can't give up. Oh, we did it. That was, like, really hard. I think I had to melt the sides of it. I'm just gonna do the other one and then refill this, but I'm saving up for a house, and then I think I have to save up for, like I said, a new PC to actually edit and render on, because the current one is just a little bit not having it. And that's gonna be like when I actually rebuild that PC, I want to do a series of videos, like going over my choices for each of the parts and like an assembly vlog and whatever, and like make a whole thing out of it. But that's gonna be an expensive PC. Like, we're gonna be spending like what, $1,200 just in the processor, and at that point you can't cheap out anything else. Like, I'm gonna need a reasonable graphics card and some real good cooling and all sorts of stuff. What do you use to record and edit? I want to start making videos, and I couldn't think of anyone better. So here, I'm gonna refill this and then I will answer your question. The cold water is not even cold. So for recording video, I use OBS. Same thing I use for streaming. I used to use Fraps and DxStory, but honestly, OBS is better and free. So OBS for recording, for sure. For recording my voice, I have used Audacity, and that is also free. It's a free open source audio recorder. It's very good for doing like a little bit of touching up on your audio after the fact. It's also very easy to use. Works on Mac and PC. For editing, I very recently switched over to Premiere Pro, but for like the last 4 years, I was using Premiere Elements. So Adobe Premiere Elements. I had 11 and then I switched up to 15. And I really like Premiere Elements because there was pretty much nothing I could ask it to do that it didn't do. You buy it once and then you have it forever. You don't have to pay monthly for the license or anything. And Premiere Elements is what I would recommend if you're looking to spend a little bit. If you want to just get started with something free, Windows Movie Maker will let you cut things up, and I might let you do picture-in-picture, but Elements was definitely, it's got like a billion transitions and effects, and it doesn't like limit you in the amount of tracks you can have, and it's got pretty much everything you need. How far are we on the muffin making process? So the muffins have been like assembled. They're currently baking. In about 9 minutes and 45 seconds, I'm going to take them out of the oven, we're going to let them cool. At that time, we're going to be mixing up some like, what do you call it? Where's my book? Here's my book. We're going to be mixing up some maple nutmeg icing with icing sugar, vanilla, nutmeg, maple syrup, and a little bit of milk, and then drizzling that over the top of them. So I would say we're about 80% done. You're my favorite YouTuber, Hazel. Aw, thanks, Steven. I'm DCing all the time at WoW. Oh, that sucks. There's been some bizarre server issues since the patch. I haven't run into a whole lot of it, but it's been a little bit sketchy. I should get today, but I have to go. See you later. Yeah, OBS. Nice free open source video editor. Oh, I missed what it is. But yeah, give it a go. How do you get over feeling self-conscious when making videos? You make a lot of them and you just accept that you're gonna look dumb. It's okay to look dumb. You're gonna look dumb. It's gonna suck. And it's like anything, you gotta do it terribly before you can do it well, and you just gotta do it. So I know that's not very helpful if you're having a lot of anxiety about it, but you just kinda gotta let go of the dream of making a good video, and then just make a video. And then for your next one, make it better. You can't try and start at the end. Hello, Gnome Priest. Hello! I do play Gnome Priest. My Gnome Priest is such a mess right now. We raid on Wednesday, which is the day after tomorrow, because the raid comes out tomorrow, right? Two Mr. Ghost opens tomorrow. So we raid on Wednesday, and I haven't looked at any of the fights. I haven't simmed any of my gear. I got the Soul of the High Priest drop for me like 2 days ago. I swear, I feel like, and I don't have any evidence, so don't take this as word, but I feel like they upped the drop rate of legendaries since 7.3, or pardon me, not 7.3, 7.25. Because I was just opening, Broken Shore, those little Legion Fall recompense caches, and I wasn't due for a legendary at all. Like, I had done pretty much nothing since I got my, I guess I could have just gotten lucky, that's always possible, but, lots of people in my guild have been getting legendaries that weren't really due for them, so I was wondering if maybe the drop rate went up. But anyways, I got the Soul of the High Priest. Haven't even gone on Hedgehog Priest to find out what people think about that. I don't even know what my legendary sets are. And I need to upgrade it, and I still don't have Sifu's, but maybe it won't be good in tune. Maybe I only need it for the, maybe I only need Sifu's for the Mage Challenge. I still haven't done the Mage Tower Challenge, my priest. I'm refusing to touch it until I get Sifu's, and I swear I'm gonna get every other legendary on the planet before I get Sifu's. Thanks for the study, company. Good luck studying. Ever since 725, my mount journal has been saying you have 106, but you know you only have, like, 71. Are you comparing the number that your mount journal shows with the one that your mount collection achievement tracks? Because those are always going to be different. Your mount journal shows you the total number of mounts that are learned in your account, while your achievement tracking, the one that you actually need for like Mountacular and whatever, is the total number that you can use on that character. So mounts that are faction specific for the other faction are the obvious one that gets cut out, but also mounts that are profession specific for professions that you don't have, or class specific for a class that you're not, aren't going to count towards that mount total, but will still show up in your mount journal. I've gotten 2 out of the 11 class mounts. You've gotten Banlu, which is really cute. Yeah, that monk. I love that monk stuff. What is your favorite race in WoW and why? My favorite race, like, lore-wise or visual? Lore-wise, I think I like the Draenei. I think they're kind of cool. I enjoy that they just crash-landed on a planet and they're just kind of going with it. They're just making the best of whatever life hands them and doing pretty good. Visually, I have a real thing for female gnomes, but male gnomes don't really do anything for me. Female gnomes, I think, are great and super cute, but for whatever reason, I wouldn't play a male gnome. I used to have a male gnome bank alt, but that was about as far as I would take it. But, for male characters, male Draenei, I have a real thing for male Draenei. Alliance or Horde? Gonna let you guess. You still don't have the stupid... Me neither! I don't have the Fox Mount! So the Fox Mount, like, it's a quest, right? And it's a quest that you start from an item that you get from either Withered Army Training or the Nightfallen Emissary Cache, or I believe it can just drop in Suramar, right? Like, those are the places you get it, right? It just won't happen for me. And I guess I stopped doing Withered Army Training, so I'm kind of giving myself there. If I really wanted the Fox Mount, I would be doing Withered Army Training every 3 days, but... Nobody wants to do Withered Army Training. How many of you guys have finished the Chromie scenario at this point? How many of you guys have actually completed Chromie? I was this close yesterday. I was this close. I was on the very last challenge, and I was at the very end of Strathholm, and I had about 25 seconds left, which was going to be enough time to finish the boss, but in order to get to the boss with only 25 seconds left, I had run past all of the trash in the second half of the Strathholm section of the Chromie scenario. So it was all following me, and at one point it all caught up with me, and I couldn't get aggro off of Chromie or, like, CC it fast enough, and she died, and I was, like, the boss was dead. I looted the Sands of Time off the boss, but you gotta take the portal back in order for it to count, and Chromie died. And I gotta do it again now. But I think tonight my extra research comes in, so I'm gonna have the increased chance for the dragons that help you complete the Chrono Shard portals. Where do you start the Chromie scenario? So you'll get a quest, I think, in Dalaran, but it sends you to the Wormrest Temple. So in Dalaran, you know those portals that are in the center of Dalaran, but like underneath? There's a portal there that'll take you directly to Wormrest Temple, so you should be able to take that portal and then go talk to Chromie and do start the scenario from there. How many mounts do I have? I have somewhere in the range of 280 mounts, 270-ish. I'm not that far from 300, but I don't really collect mounts. They just kind of happen. So I'm more interested in collecting pets, and I'm trying very hard to collect all of the class specific pets. Something really weird actually happened to me with my the warlock pets. I have my warlock at level like 106, and I have been doing the Ritual of Doom thing every day to try and get the Hateful Eye to drop, and it just won't happen. Like, it's happening to everybody else but me, and of course they never want to trade it to me. And because if they don't have it already, that's fine, they can keep it. But it wouldn't drop. And then in the last couple of days, I've, like, formed the group and gone to do it. And it's like, you can't benefit from Ritual of Doom more than once a day. And I'm like, dude, I haven't done it in a whole week. You haven't let me. And I don't know what to do. I'm tempted to just level a Demon Hunter and do it on the Demon Hunter instead, because they also have access to the Hateful Eye Pet. Mm. You got to the first boss and you gave up. You died to him 4 times now. If you're talking about the Satyr, on the Chromacenary, he's rough. If you have the Prydaz legendary, absolutely wear Prydaz for the Satyr, and possibly the other bosses, but you really want to wear Prydaz. The other thing is you can always start somewhere else, and as you progress through it, you'll get those Sands of Time buffs, especially if you have the rep to get that, if you have the rep and you've researched that thing that gives you double Sands of Time. And sometimes those can give you the Height of the Bronze that gives you 10% damage reduction, and that'll stack. So by the end of my last scenario, I was running around with 70% damage reduction. So if you're having issues with the Satyr, you can just do them later. sorry, that was a terrible rhyme. But if you have issues with the Satyr, you can come back to him at a later time and do so with some of that Height of the Bronze from the Sands of Time. I only have 80 mounts. I have barely 235. There's just so many mounts in the game now. And also Warlords. Warlords of Draenor. If you played through Warlords of Draenor and you did like the mount collecting back then, it just spit mounts out at you. They were just like on vendors. And then the stables thing in Warlords at the garrison had like a whole bunch of mounts. Okay, so we're about 2 minutes away from taking the muffins out of the oven. So I'm going to move my stool. I'm going to mix up this maple nutmeg icing. And we're going to get ready to... I think I can just do it in a bowl. I think I just need to mix all this up in a bowl, so... I have a bowl. Let's use this bowl. Oh, man. I feel like it's never gonna get room temperature in here ever again. It's just too warm. Okay. We play the new Demon Hunter. I created a Demon Hunter. I got it out of its starting area. That's about as much Demon Hunter as I have ever played in my whole life. Okay, so. Icing sugar. Vanilla, nutmeg. I think I have nutmeg. Where's vanilla? Nutmeg. It always says ground nutmeg, and I've never in my life seen nutmeg that wasn't ground. Like, what other ways of nutmeg are there? Put icing on pretty much everything I'd eat if I could. I had such a sweet tooth. I used to have a sweet tooth as a kid, but I really grew out of it. Vanilla, nutmeg, maple syrup, and milk. Okay. You know what's actually really funny is because I'm in America, but I'm from Canada, you'd think that at home in Canada, we would have all the good maple syrup. But honestly, at home in Canada, whenever we were buying maple syrup, we would just buy, like, the cheap stuff. I was worried that text was from my mod telling me that, like, my stream had completely broken, but... No, I'm just, There we go. Okay. So, 1 cup of icing sugar. Go over here. You only play Demon Hunters to climb high and then float down. The double jump thing looks really useful. Like, for example, in the Deaths of Chromie scenario, people that can double jump, so Demon Hunters, can completely, like, at the first time through their Black Dragon Shrine, they can completely skip a lot of it because they can jump up a little part that you're only supposed to be able to jump down. All right. I wanted to get, like, a snapware thing for the icing sugar, but I never really keep that much icing sugar around, and I very rarely make icing. Hang on. Okay, oh yeah, I had a cup of icing sugar. I need a knife. You quit WoW mid-mop, you came back for Legion, you missed it in WoW, but is it really worth it to go back and level through Draenor? Get the mounts from the garrison. If you're collecting mounts, then yeah, there's quite a few mounts. It's kind of like going back and doing the Argent tournament. It's annoying, but there's a lot of mounts. But if you're just playing the content just to play it, no. Nobody really remembers Draenor fondly just yet. We need one more expansion to go buy, and then people are going to be like, oh, you know what? I miss Warlords. It's the two-expansion rule. Two expansions ago, people get nostalgic. Happens every time. People hated Cataclysm until Warlords came out, and then people were like, you know what? Cata was great. Okay, so that's a cup of that. It says a dash of vanilla, which I don't even know how to do. A dash of vanilla and a pinch of nutmeg, all right. Well, I'm just gonna, like, throw some in then. Sure. Yep, it smells like nutmeg. and then it wants me to do 2 teaspoons of syrup and 3 tablespoons of milk. So a little bit of vanilla. Sure. Seems like a dash. Less is always more with that stuff. You don't want to do too much. Made it WoW, not much love for that expansion. I don't know anybody who likes it. WoW was a little bit of a disaster. At least, though, they're kind of learning from it, and I think they're learning from Legion 2, and I think they're always going to be learning. I don't think they're ever going to get it, like, right, but as long as they're doing better, that's all I can really ask of them. Oh, that splashed. Oh my gosh, this thing is it's so hard to measure at a tablespoon from such a gigantic thing of milk. So we're going to start to mix that up a little bit. Should I get an alliance tattoo? I mean, if you really want one, you have to consider, though, that because the tattoo is going to be on you for the rest of your life, and WoW is almost certainly not going to last forever, you have to consider whether or not you want it to have that tattoo in, like, 50 years when it's been a long time since you played WoW. And if WoW is, like, a huge part of your life, and you want to, like, memorialize it as that, then that's fine. But I personally trend towards tattoos that are not really of anything time-relative or time-sensitive, so that it means the same thing to me as the years pass. Okay, so I also need 2 teaspoons of maple syrup. And I think I need another hand. I think I need to use both hands for this. One. Ah! Too much. Alright, well, it's fine. I put a little less milk in there anyways. Put these things away, because I will spill maple syrup all over everything. And Canada would just never take me back. Muffins smell really good. Alright, so I'm gonna very carefully just mix. It's weird mixing milk with syrup. That's not a thing I've ever done before in my life. Wrath was pretty great. Oh no, I didn't like Wrath at all. I know it's like sacrilege to say that, but personally, I didn't like Wrath. I thought that the questing was slow and poorly paced. The places, you know what, part of it was just an aesthetic thing. I thought Wrath was too gritty. It was a little bit too depressing. It was a little bit too doomy. And I guess that's cool, and that's like a video game thing. But I really liked the, like, Legion is gritty and depressing without being, like, ugly, you know? Like, it's still got some really beautiful zones. Yeah, no, there's a little bit of vanilla in here. I already did. You caught them all in Pokemon? Should you do the same in WoW with pets? You should definitely give it a go. It is a challenge and a half. I don't think the spoon is really getting this job done. I probably should have used a whisk, but it's too late now. I'm like 12% less cool. Why am I 12% less cool? How did I get less cool? I think I'm pretty cool. I mean, I have 12 muffins and you don't have any muffins. Unless you made muffins also, but I'm like pretty sure that you don't have any muffins right now, so I'm 12 muffins cooler than you for the moment. This is just started watching. How are you? I'm doing really good. I am quite warm. It is quite a high temperature in here. But we have some maple nutmeg icing. And I'm going to just start to drizzle this on some muffins. So those are pretty. Those are a little bit cold down. This isn't going to be very pretty. probably should have made the icing thinner because it glued down kind of thick. I'm going to show you guys the muffins. But they're done. We did them. You made brownies yesterday. See how brownies covered with frosting? That's true. Stream's lagging. It's running fine on my PC, but it's lagging my MP3. Oh, no. Mm. Well, if it makes you feel any better, we're pretty much done here. I'm going to show you the muffins. Can I show you the muffins? Do I have enough cable leeway? I need to move the muffins. Way too long to realize this is a stream. Alright, so they look a little crazy, but they smell real good. So, I promise we're good. Anyways. Okay, Melinda didn't want it to end. The VOD's gonna be up tomorrow, so if you missed any part of it, I'll put that up, and I think I can put the recipe in the description. I think I can do that. But you guys should totally buy the Warcraft Cookbook. It's available on Amazon. It's good stuff. It's got really crazy great recipes in it, and it'll let you make muffins like these ones. So, thank you so much for coming. I'm going to be streaming again on Friday. Normal WoW stream time, 3 p.m. Pacific to 5 p.m. Pacific. And in the meantime, I'm going to get back to making videos. So thank you guys so much for watching, and have a wonderful, wonderful day.